He who was born of the union between human and monster. You succeeded in defeating Randolfo the Tyrant. Many moons have waxed and waned since you first swore this moment would come. That day, you rejected the chance to live life as a human in favor of one as a monster. Do you still seek to tread the monster's path? Or will you choose humanity? I expected you would say as much. Then go forth, unchanged and resolute, blessed with the dignity of remaining true to yourself. I take comfort, knowing that you have found peace with who you are. Until we meet again.
Our journey is finally at an end. I think it's time for a well-deserved break. What? You're going back out to train up your monster some more? Huh. I guess a monster wrangler's journey never truly ends. Well, I can't let you have all the fun. This sounds like a great chance to bulk up my collection of magical ingredients. Let's hit the road!
Wherefore am I ashamed to weep beneath thy panoply? Of wonders sacrosanct and most magnificent. Off on another trip, are you? I'm glad I caught you when I did then. I have something to tell you. Dear brother, remember how there are supposed to be three beings in the unholy trinity? Well, I think I might have found the last one. Ventura. It's woken up too, and is heading for a place called the Wisp Woods. We have to stop it, or the world will be engulfed in flame. But together, we can destroy that foul creature. You'll need this to reach the Wisp Woods. I'll go on ahead. Don't leave me waiting, will you?
Thank you. find Ventura.
I'm guessing they don't have a big hitter around these parts. Should make it pretty simple to recruit the local monsters.
I'm glad you finally made it. Come, let's go and take care of Ventura. There's not a moment to lose. In fact, we should probably go together. I hope you don't mind. It's this way. We'd better get a move on.
So this is him, huh? The last of the unholy trinity, Ventura.
Our little sleepy head is waking up. Take your seats. The show is about to begin. Ventura! Harbinger of Oblivion! Be a good boy and obey my words.
We'll be right back.
An exemplary showing. But wait, you mustn't kill him. All we have to do now is follow his spirit. It will lead us to our final destination.
Would you mind telling us what you're really up to?
Well, I suppose I can tell you a little story. Once upon a time, before humans or monsters even existed, a certain Zenithian sought to betray the Zenith Dragon and become a god herself. Vanjura's spirit should take us right to her. I would very much like to meet this woman face to face. Come on, let's go.
Doing?
It's desperate to see its mother. She's the Zenithian traitor, the would-be usurper, Azabel. She birthed the unholy trinity to destroy the world so that she could create it anew. Her actions caused untold pain and suffering. She is the greatest sinner of all. For her crimes, Azabel was banished to another dimension by the Zenith Dragon himself. If she were to return, she would surely birth another Estark and renew her attempts to annihilate everything. If you truly wish to save the world, as I do, then Azabel must be destroyed. This is a battle we have no choice but to win.
Not allow it!
Wormsworth, you can't stay out of my business, can you?
Fool! Refuse to heed my warnings, will you? Then you go no further!
Thank you. here!
Has the warning I gave in Grimglow Cave slipped your mind? I told you that he intends nothing less than the total destruction of the world.
Wormsworth, are you trying to worry these good people? That's not my intention at all. It's just a rather unfortunate side effect. He's not wrong, though. The end of this world will be my fault. The portal is open now. It shouldn't be too much longer before Azabel wakes. Remember that if you do not defeat her, she will destroy the world. Of that, I am certain. There, she has awoken. Azabel the Dawnbringer.
By whom am I roused from sleep, pray tell? Is Majora, Dumajora, Venjora, was it you who came to wake me? But what have you become? The lowly beings of this world are cruel indeed. My darlings, rest a moment in my embrace. Only from the depths of infinite despair can this world be reborn in all the glory it deserves. Now, my beloved children, we have a world to make anew. Interlopers, I bestow the honor of a death more magnificent than life itself. The dawn of evolution is poised to break, and you will be the catalysts for the fires of destruction.
This is the big one. There's no backing out now.
here!
Thank you.
Destruction. Can this world be saved?
Oh, you don't have to tell me that. Now, before I bring about the end, there is something I must first create. My utopia. But for you, Azabelle, this is goodbye. Under different circumstances, I feel we might have become friends. Right. Shall we begin?
Seriously, what is this all about? Are you really trying to destroy the world?
As I've already explained, that's just a side effect. You see, there is someone that I'm rather excited to meet. My mother. I've missed you ever so much, Mother.
Ludo. Oh, how I've waited for this moment. Is it time for our wish to come true?
It is. We can finally have our utopia now. Sorry it took so long. Are you ready to create it?
I What in the world are you doing?
We are related to the ancient Elzetian elves. One of their priestesses had the power to create worlds. It was her duty to transform herself into the world that would forever contain Azabel. That priestess was my mother. Now I'm simply releasing her from that eternal burden.
So, what does this have to do with the utopia you keep mentioning?
Don't you think there's too much sadness in this world? I know you understand. After all, you were unable to finish Father, even though he tried to kill you. And in Grimglow Cave, family should never have to fight like we did there. We're supposed to love one another. This world is nothing but a botched experiment. That's why Mother and I are going to make a new one. Ours will be a paradise, free from fighting and quarrels, a place of true beauty. I want you to come with us. The three of us can live together in peace. Perhaps you need a moment to mull things over. You should know that once our utopia is complete, it will begin to erode away at this world and eventually destroy it. Anyway, my offer stands. Give it some thought. I'll wait right here for you. I'm ever so glad you came. The prospect of a perfect world is irresistible, isn't it?
You've got it all wrong. We've come to stop you, not join you.
Sorry, but this is between family. I'd rather you kept your noses out. You needn't give me that look. I just thought we needed a little privacy. Now, look around you. The world Mother has made is one of generosity, one of tolerance. There will be no violence here, no animosity. When that other world is consumed, we will leave only happiness in its place. Tell me, honestly, don't you think you've suffered enough? You lost your home, your mother, father abandoned you. That world is built on misery. Well, here you need suffer no more. Now, it's time I asked you again. Will you come with Mother and I and live in our utopia, free from torment? Thank you. But I know you're only saying that so as not to hurt my feelings. Seems we must face off one last time. I truly hoped for a different ending. The brotherly love triumphed over hate. Goodbye, my brother. Roused from slumber by a breeze, half-evaporated dreams, I turn to where you used to sleep, expectantly.
Ha!
beaten again by my big brother. But what can you do? This was but one eventuality. I should be leaving. I'm not sure I can bear another moment in the tragedy of this world. Before I go, I will say this. There may come a day when the miseries of this place overwhelm you. Should that happen, all you need do is call my name, and I'll be there for you. Mother dearest, would you leave this world intact? For them? So this is goodbye. Just know that I'm proud to call you my brother. I recall the dream I had of flowers in palest gray. Petals fall, the fragrance lingers. The day you left.